What you're seeing now is not gameplay from the game Limbo, or a similar looking game. It's a scene I built completely from scratch, using the free vector program Inkscape, with a little help from the Godot engine to put it in an interactive mockup. I wanted to demonstrate the point that you can absolutely create compelling game art, even in the style of Limbo, using nothing but vector tools, a mouse, and a bit of know-how. So in this video, I'll walk you through how I made everything, and hopefully convince you that vector software might just be the tool you didn't know you needed for your next game project. Limbo left a huge mark on me. Few games have visuals that feel as artistic and emotional as Limbo's, so this is a bit of an homage. Also, the silhouette-only style is perfect for working with vectors. It's clean, flexible, and surprisingly easy to build if you know what you're doing. That said, it's been over 15 years since I last played it. The only thing I remember is the opening forest section, that eerie atmosphere stuck with me. So I grabbed a reference gameplay video and decided to replicate the feel of that area. Not copy it asset by asset, but capture the same mood. Still, I'm not promising it'll look exactly like the original. There are a ton of visual effects in Limbo that are probably baked into the engine, and I don't have much experience with complex parallax scrolling or 2D lighting. So as I write this, I genuinely don't know how close it'll get. First step is roughing out the entire level. This helps me visualize the structure and get a better sense of how things will look before refining anything. These rectangles will represent one screen width. They are mainly there to help me establish the proportions and the overall geometry of the level. I also thought they'd help later with the parallax scrolling setup, but more on that in a minute. For now, I'm just blocking things out using simple shapes to build something inspired by the forest area from Limbo, not a one-to-one copy. The goal is to capture the feeling, not to recreate it asset by asset. Obviously, for this demo, I went with something way less complex than the original game. There are fewer layers, and the details in each of them is simplified. The same goes for the visual effects, which I'll get into later. One of the most iconic parts of Limbo's art style is that beautiful parallax scrolling with all those layered silhouettes. I never actually worked with parallax before, and I wasn't even sure how to approach it in the engine, so I decided to do a quick test in Godot to figure out how it all works. I went with the simplest approach, exporting each layer as a single object. That's probably not how you'd handle it in a real game, but for a demo, it gets the job done. Now, because parallax scrolling moves each layer at a different speed relative to the camera, I knew I'd probably have to tweak a lot of things, jumping back and forth between Inkscape and Godot. That's what gave me the idea to leave those rectangles as a camera size guide, hoping they'd help me line things up better later on. Spoiler, they didn't. They just got in the way. But at least now I know. But first, it would be nice to have a character in the demo. And I'm not animating one from scratch. It's too much work and it will take too much time. I first tried looking for a Limbo sprite sheet, but I couldn't find a proper one anywhere. And just when I was about to give up and draw a quick placeholder, I found this sprite sheet from the remake of the game, A Boy and His Blob. The character's proportions and animations were perfect. So I imported into Inkscape a few sheets that could pass as an idle, run, and jump animation. Because we only need the silhouette, I used a trace bitmap tool to get these shapes, and with a couple of ellipses for eyes and a few quick tweaks, I had something that really worked. Now, back to the parallax test. I exported all the layers and dropped them into Godot to test the parallax scrolling options. I also added the character along with a quick script for running, jumping, and collisions. Here is how it worked out. Turns out I was worried for nothing. Making parallax scrolling in Godot was way easier than I expected. Once I started fiddling with the settings, everything just worked. I didn't have to constantly go back and forth between Inkscape and Godot like I feared. I had the power to adjust everything I needed inside the engine itself, which was a huge relief for me. What was more complicated were the visual effects. I wanted to see how many of Limbo's post-processing effects I could replicate directly inside of Godot. Vignette, noise, blur, glow, volumetric light. After 6 or 7 hours of wrestling with the shaders and asking ChatGPT for help, I managed to pull off a few of them. But it was rough. A lot of the answers I got were outdated or just wrong, and it slowed me down a lot. So I changed the plan again. I'll bake most of the effects directly into Inkscape layers. That includes depth of field and light rays. I'll finish each layer fully, then export them as complete backgrounds, just like the roughs. Now it's time to refine, and this part is easy. These are the silhouettes of branches, grass, and other forest bits. I made them the same way as the character, traced them from images, turned into vector shapes. They are vectors, so I can cut, merge, and reshape them however I want. Starting with the foreground, I begin layering these elements in. I'm not too worried about the exact placement. Once we move everything into Godot, I'll make some adjustments. I'm also using Inkscape's blur slider to fake the depth of field. I wish I could use a real DOF shader in Godot, but I couldn't pull it. This way I'm doing it is less than perfect. The ideal would have been to use the engine itself, but like I said, I'm not a programmer and ChatGPT was not being kind to me, especially with this particular shader. The one type of drawing I'm doing manually is sculpting the ground, so it looks more natural. Basically just adding some nodes and making it look nice and organic. I barely had to smooth any of the nodes, because when you look at them from far away, it still looks nice with simple straight edges. Super easy to do. After that, it's just a matter of pasting grass and branches all over the place. I repeated the same steps for the first background layer and a bit of the second one. First sculpting the ground and then pasting the grass and branch shapes to make it more natural. But here's the thing. The farther away, the less important it is to sculpt these shapes, since they are going to be more and more blurred. By the time we get to the back, it's mostly just large shapes and a soft light. At this point, I'm done with the drawing. What's left to do is the final touches in Godot, which are mostly shaders and other boring programming stuff, which I'm not gonna cover. The drawing part wasn't hard at all. Most of the challenge came from trying to replicate the engine effects and setting up everything in Godot. If you wanted, you could do this too. Just check out my channel for real-time step-by-step tutorials where I show you exactly how to do this kind of work. And if you want to get started even faster, I have a bunch of asset packs and free resources in the description to help you jump in right away. Make sure to check them out. But if you really want to level up fast, I highly recommend grabbing my full courses bundle. It includes over 70 hours of training across 13 courses covering game art, character design, background design, rendering, and more. It's currently on heavy discount and it's the best way to support the channel while mastering vector illustration. Link in the description. And here it is. With a couple of final effects added, I'm happy with how it turned out. I did what I could, and I think it captures the Limbo vibe pretty well. That said, this was nothing like the Among Us recreation. Between my lack of coding skills and ChatGPT's sometimes weird answers, it was a painful process. Fun and rewarding, but painful. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Even though the illustration work was simple, the project felt big, and honestly really satisfying. If there is another game you'd like to see me tackle in Vector, let me know in the comments. And of course, like and subscribe if you enjoyed this. It really helps the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.